Hello, it's Keith here, and this is lesson 16 of the platform-specific series of my 6502 assembly tutorials. We've been looking at the joystick at a wide variety of systems. This week, we're going to be doing the VIC-20. Now, the VIC-20 has a digital joystick, and we're going to learn how to read from it. It's actually connected to some of the ports that do other things, but it's pretty straightforward to read from. All we need to do is configure it and get it reading. So let's learn how to do that today. Now, rather strangely on the VIC-20, even though it's only got five buttons, it actually uses two ports. So we've got just five bits split over two ports, but that's not sort of strange. What is rather strange is that fire, left, down and up are in one port, a right is in the other port. You would have kind of expected fire to be in the other port, but that's not the way they've done things. So that's the ports that we need to read in. We need to use 911F to get that right button, 9120 to get fire, left, down and up. And then what we need to do is we need to make sure those ports are configured for reading and not writing. And so we need to write bits to some of those ports to configure things. Now, in these tutorials, we use a common format on all our 6502Z18-68000 systems. We use a single byte, up, down, left and right in bits 0 to 3, fire 1, 2 and 3 if they exist, which in this case they don't, in 4, 5 and 6, and start if it exists in bit 7. And we store these in zero page entries marked ZH and ZL. This is to match the Z80 tutorials. So let's see the code in action today. Now, today's example is only going to load in a single joystick. We're not trying to emulate two joysticks in any way. So all we're doing is we're reading in and showing to the screen. And so here's the correct joystick. And if I press up on my joystick here, then down, left, right, and any one of these fires should do the job. So there we go. We've got four directions and one fire button. And joystick 2 doesn't work in this case, so it's just defaulting to FF. It's compatible with the other code, that's why we're setting it to FF. So how do we actually read in the joystick? Well, we have these two ports that we need to read in from, but you'll see there's some remmed out code here, and the reason for that is that we can actually kind of skip doing some of our setting here. We need to read in from port A, but it seems by default that's already set, so I've disabled these two commands just to save a little bit of memory. The other thing is port B we need to set to read, because by default it won't be. We need that top bit to be set to read, so we set it to a zero here so we can get our write button. But when it actually comes to setting it back again, we don't need to bother, because if we're not using the firmware, we don't care what the default is, we just need it to be right for our reading. So I've disabled this reset here. So if you were using the firmware keyboard routine, you'd probably find they wouldn't work anymore, so you might need to turn that back on. But to try and save as much memory as possible, I've left them in here so you can see them, but we're only setting what we need to get things working today. So at this point, we've now set our up, down, left and fire buttons to read, and our right button here to read as well. So what we're now going to do is we're going to read in that right button from the top bit of port B, and we're going to store it into ZAS, and that's a zero page entry. And then we're going to set ZH and ZL to 255. This effectively blanks out all of the unused keys of ZH and blanks out ZL, because we have no buttons or no joystick for that port. So now what we're going to do is we're going to read in fire, left, down and up from port 911F, port A. We're going to then shift across left three bits, and this will effectively pop out the fire button. We then shift that into ZH. Now what we want is the right button, because if you remember, after fire one, we've got the right button first here, so we're effectively building this in this direction here. So we've popped in our right button here, and then we shift out our left, down and up, shifting them all into ZH one at a time. And that's really all there is to it. The only slight inconvenience is that the right is kind of in this odd place in this other register, but that's pretty straightforward and not too hard to get in there. As I say, the only thing is you might need to make sure you reset things correctly if you were going to use that keyboard, but we're not using our keyboard yet. And we'll deal with that in a later lesson if we do look at keyboards on the VIC-20. Now, one thing I will point out is it is possible to read in from an analog joystick on the VIC-20, but I believe the fire buttons are actually shared across the two, so I don't think you could actually use the analog joystick and the digital joystick at the same time. I may be wrong on that, but that's what I've kind of glanced at seeing the documentation. We only use digital joysticks in this tutorials because we are looking for a common platform across all of our systems, so we're not going to look at the analog joypad. But anyway, I just wanted to mention that to you. Anyway, I hope you found this interesting. We're going to be looking at the VIC-20 again later on, so please subscribe to the channel if you want to see that. We'll be looking at how to do sound and things later. Thanks for watching today anyway, and goodbye.